Continue playing, girl.
But yeah, y'all, we about to make some. The kids want some damn tacos, so I'm gonna show y'all how to make some bootleg tacos, okay?
So we got some burger here, okay?
It look like I'm fat right now because I got this waist thing on. Let me take this off. I look fat. Don't.
Hey Siri, play 2000s hip hop and R&B.
What are you guys doing tonight? But yeah, so I got these hamburger patties, right? Now see that? Okay, I got these hamburger patties. We gonna take, how many is this? One, two, three, four, five. It's just for the kids because mama, like I said, I ain't had time to order groceries, so we making it work. So I got my hamburger patties that I defrosted in the microwave.
Okay.
My hands are clean. Can y'all see me? Y'all, my kitchen is dirty too, by the way, so sorry.
Put my little skillet on here. Mm-hmm. Damn it, I ain't got no beef bouillons either.
See, this is one of the meals that you make when you, when you in between grocery shopping. So, I ain't got no beef bouillons, I ain't got nothing, but we're gonna put a little chicken broth in there. You know, you gotta do what you gotta do. So, I'm gonna drop my meat in there, like so. I don't know if y'all can, let me move this up this way so y'all can actually see what I'm doing. What are y'all doing? Are y'all cooking tonight? What's going on? I just realized yesterday, if y'all hopped in my live yesterday, I was talking about how I be trying to respond back to y'all on live because y'all be talking about me like, you know, I never say anything back, but I can talk back to y'all. So I may not be able to text back, but I can talk back. Hello? Okay. But you know how on like Thursday night, I usually, I be trying to cook at least like 5 to 6 times a week, but I fast food be calling my name. Hey Sabrina. Oh, thank you, girl. I'm sure you're pretty too. I look a mess, but thank you. What you doing? Are you cooking tonight? But like Thursday usually be an in-between day. Like sometimes I'll be like, you know what? It's Thursday. It's about to be the end of the week, but I'm trying my hardest not to like order fast food because baby, I'd be this quick to be wanting to order DoorDash, you feel me? So yeah, and then I don't believe in cutting shit up, y'all, so I usually use frozen green peppers and onions. Let me show you.
Mama ain't cutting shit up, okay?
Do y'all be using these? My husband, he be talking about me. He be like, girl, why you don't? First of all, they are the same thing, okay? This is what they use at the restaurants. Hi, Draco, how are you? What y'all doing? Talk to me.
Add these little peppers in this thing. Like that.
Let me make sure y'all can see what I'm actually doing. Can y'all see what I'm doing? Y'all, excuse my kitchen. It's trifling too. You know, Thursdays is my cleanup bag. So, it's a little dirty in here. But we're clean people. Sometimes. Got my spatula. Y'all, normally I'd be having my apron on, but I ain't got my apron on today. For y'all, the ones that just joined the live, y'all, we making tacos, but balling on a budget tacos. We using some hamburger patties, but let me show you, because the kids, they love these little shells. I ain't even got the real kind. I just realized these don't say Dorito on it. But do y'all like these? I love these. Like, you know the ones that they be having at Taco Bell? Baby, Taco Bell, who? This is all you need. Okay. 70s. Let's go. Who do I know you? 76ers Philly. Period. Oh, and did y'all know, if y'all use these, did y'all know y'all supposed to put these in the oven? I was like today years old when I found out that you're supposed to put these in the oven. Maybe I just be eating them raw. So we're gonna put these in the oven. We're gonna do the right thing, you guys. But because we balling on a budget and we bootlegging dinner tonight, you can always put them bad boys in the microwave. Girl, the kids, they don't care. What'd she say? Yum. Y'all like those? I love those. My son, he likes to take these and put the like a soft taco around it. I guess it makes like a gordita crunch. He's an old man. So, yeah.
Now I gotta get the garlic out, y'all.
I told y'all I don't be cutting up shit. This right here, this, baby. What? It's a little. Make sure it ain't old.
Alright, what's going on? Put a little bit of this garlic in there.
And see, a thing that people don't be knowing, y'all, you gotta put some, either get some beef broth. Well, it depends. Whatever kind of taco you make, I'm making beef, so get you some beef broths or some beef bouillons and put that in your taco plus taco seasoning. Baby.
What? So I'm putting a little bit of this in there. A little pinch. Y'all see? A little pinch. Because that garlic be strong. Copyrighted. Can y'all hear that music?
Let me know if y'all can hear the music in the back. Can y'all hear it? Because I don't want YouTube to be hating on me. Because I'll be... Normally it'll say if it picked up a thing. What are you guys doing tonight as I'm waiting for my meat to heat up?
It's taking forever. See all that? How them little patties made, baby, hamburgers, right? And then,
because we're balling on a budget,
let me show you something else. Y'all, I ain't got nothing. I need to go grocery
shopping. I ain't got no lettuce, right? So we gonna use some spinach. Same thing, y'all. Green is green. It don't matter. It does not matter. It's healthier anyway. I don't like romaine. Romaine be looking dusty. So I be taking this. I would cut it up, but I ain't doing that either. I'ma like just cut it apart. So I'ma rinse off some spinach. And I got no tomato either.
It's giving ghetto. Y'all, I ain't got no nothing.
I need some stamps. Somebody selling some stamps. I probably can't say that on here, can I? Baby, we ain't got no tomatoes, so we're gonna take some we're gonna take a can of tomatoes. That's gonna be our tomatoes. And then sour cream. The kids, they don't like a lot of toppings on there. I got some jalapenos in a jar. And then I also have some sour cream because I'm a sour cream. Make sure y'all wipe y'all cans off because they be nasty.
I'm making the tacos right now, boots. Yeah.
You want taco? Yeah. Chase, so y'all, I'm gonna open up this, make sure my shit ain't expired because I'll be having stuff in here for a minute. Yeah, shout out to you. You know, I don't know if you noticed about me, my husband is from Philly, and the Philadelphia Eagles are my favorite football team. So, yeah, shout out to 76 Philly Love. How you doing? I'm gonna be in Philly in a couple of days. Well, let me not lie, I'm gonna be in Allentown, Lehigh Valley. I don't know if you're familiar, if you live out there. I'm be out there, but shout out to Philly. Do you like cheesesteaks? If you do, what's your favorite cheesesteak spot? If you from Philly, what's your favorite cheesesteak spot? Mine's is Jim's. But I like Gino's too. It depends. But Jim's, it's always going to be Jim's no matter what.
Okay, our hamburger's looking good. Sissy, you want taco?
Oh, okay.
See, and then when your meat start getting brown and stuff, then you can go ahead and add in your other seasoning. I'm gonna add a little pepper. Okay. I really just be adding a little bit of everything. Don't put no season salt in your food. That's the only thing I'll be saying. If you don't know how to cook, use chicken bouillon for everything. That's all you need. Oh, I'm putting a little Cajun. Sorry, guys. I'm not telling you what I'm putting there. A little Cajun. Make a little spice. I got my taco seasoning. And also, these things.
See, this is how I know I bought the fake ones. Because the real... Or wait. Maybe they do. Let me not get on here lying. These things right here... What'd you say? The wheels on the bus go round and round.
That was just, I'll be messing these up. I can pull them by. Well, yeah, see, these aren't the right ones.
Because I'm about to say, the real ones, when you buy the real I forget the brand. I think it's Ortega that actually makes the Dorito brand. Yeah, it is. They give you like extra seasoning, so you can put the seasoning in your meat, okay?
So we're gonna put this in there too. Make sure it didn't expire.
But yeah, y'all, I attempted to go, remember when I don't know if anybody was in my live that was in my live last night. I've been saying like, oh, the whole month of April, what the hell? I was gonna go live on YouTube every day. So I think I'm gonna just go live every night at, let's say 8:00. 8:00 Eastern Standard Time. So if you guys wanna talk or chat it up, yours truly will be on.
We got our little taco seasoning in there, you know what I'm saying?
Let me show y'all what it looking like, just a little bit. It looking like that. Okay. But I'm gonna show you when we put it together. It's gonna be fire. And y'all, I don't know about y'all. Do y'all drain y'all grease? Because the grease, I feel like, is what, only when it comes to beef, obviously. But it be making the tacos good. But that might just be my inner fat girl. You okay? Y'all not saying nothing. Why y'all don't want to talk? Y'all just be on here just looking and lurking. What you doing? Y'all, I'm cheating on my little diet, too. I be doing intermittent fasting. I'm not supposed to be eating, but I'm hungry. And I ain't eating nothing today.
So, I don't care. Sissy, you want taco? You gotta taste the meat, too.
Now, I'm gonna tell you how fast I put this together. It's about to be fire. I'm gonna take a little bit more of this. You're supposed to put water in. I don't ever follow no directions, though. Yeah, I'm not doing that. I'm just gonna put a little seasoning in this bad boy. Say that for next time. Sissy, how many tacos do you want? You want one or you want two? You want three? No way. No, you just want one taco. You want one or two? You want one or two? Okay. Bro, you gotta be careful with these because I always be breaking these. I might have some in there already open. Let me see. Little ASMR, guys. See, look at me, fucking up. Like, fuck some up. What the hell? Y'all, I do own a pair of kitchen scissors, but I just don't know where they at. Son, how many times? You want two?
Three?
No, you're not getting three. What's that say? Y'all ain't here saying something bad? Of course. Of course. Okay. So people are going to start getting blocked. Okay. How do we do that? What's it say? Automatically help a review hidden. Okay. I don't know if y'all can see that. People in here being nasty. I don't want none of y'all. I'm happily married. Just letting y'all know, okay? I'm going to be completely honest with you. Sis, I'm just going to heat everybody's stuff up on your plate. Son! Say, son!
Say, get up here. How many tacos you want?
Oh,
there's two. Okay.
Because
their
sister was like banging down.
So like, I hear anything. Oh.
I'm like, huh? Because I knew someone was calling me, but I didn't know it was here.
Ain't nobody else here, son.
Sorry.
Who else is here?
I don't know.
Okay, you see, Chef
girl RC. Let's put a little cheese on those bad boys. You need to stop. I'm gonna put a little cheesy cheese. Love. Okay, the kids, they don't be wanting. I'm gonna show y'all what mine's look like. They don't be wanting nothing on theirs. They're no fun. And we putting these in the microwave. Like I said, you supposed to be putting these things in the I put cheese on there, baby.
Oh, no, we don't.
Okay, is that okay?
No, we don't.
You supposed to put them things in the oven, but we ain't got time for all that because I'm hungry and it's already late. And like I said, I do intermittent fasting. And, girlfriend was supposed to be done eating for today. Yeah, you supposed to put these in the oven for like 5 to 6 minutes on 325. We're not doing that. Okay. Son, give me a plate. And I'm a big girl. She be eating. Okay, period. Oh, yes, I remember you. What's your... I'm not good at reading these names. I'm so sorry. So, is your name... is it... I'm going to tear it up. Shamika? I don't want to tear it up. But, yes, I remember you. Yes. How's your workout journey been going? I'm going to be honest with you, girl. Mine is like... I'm just learning to accept that you can't look at them. You can't look at the scale because I've definitely slimmed down. But, like, baby, the scale... it ain't cute. But granted, I'm 6 foot, y'all. Like, I don't know if y'all realize that. Okay, so that is your... okay, is it... Sheik? Is it Sheik? Is that your name? I want to call you by your name. But yeah, that's awesome. Do you have a channel? Let me make sure I'm subscribed to you. I want to make sure, girl, because I... or I might have. What's it say? What is people saying? Boy... you better be lucky I can't block you right now. What'd she say? Enjoy. Yeah. And that's what it is. It's all about it being a lifestyle, you know? Yay! Y'all, these are the kids playing tacos. But I'm going to show y'all what mamas look like. Here you go. You good?
It's like a taco party.
It's a taco party. Period. I'm just going to have to. I'm going to be modest today. Yeah, girl, like, I mean, I would say, fit, like, physically, I look like I have, but no. If anything, I've kind of gained weight. And I'm like, it's muscle. People be trying to make me feel better, like the coaches and stuff, the class that I go to. They be like, oh, it's muscle. But I'm like, girl, I want to look on a scale and it be, like, in the hundreds. She's in the twos. She's not cute. You know, I got big boobs and stuff, but I want to be skinny, you know?
Skinny like me.
Period. Oh, that's because you don't eat nothing. So that ain't the same thing. I want to be skinny, but be healthy skinny. Y'all, normally my big ass, normally I'll make like, girl, about 6 of them. But she's being modest. They good, ain't they? Mm-hmm. A little late night snacky snack. I put cheese on mine, right? Mm-hmm. I'm realizing, girl, that the beauty of fitness is way more than how the body looks, but how you feel. Yeah, you right. And that was my thing, because, girl, a year ago, when I'd be playing with my kids, baby, and I still lightweight be out of breath, but, like, that's the thing. I'm like, I'm 30. How old am I? 32. I'm like, I should not feel old like that. So, yeah, you're absolutely right. And it's like, it helps with your routine. Like, days where I get up and I don't go work out, I be, you know, I kind of be having a bad day, but when I do work out, I be feeling good. Here, I'm going to put mine in the microwave. Good. Here, scoot this closer to you. So I feel you. It's a balance. And that's why I be like, I don't put myself on like a restrictive diet. I don't know. Do you diet? Like, obviously, I try to watch what I eat, but I do intermittent fasting. I feel like that's helped a lot, too, like with helping how I look. I don't feel like I look always, like, I'll go back and look at pictures and I'm like, right now I look like I got rolls because I got this waist thing on. But like, I'll go on Instagram or stuff and look back at pictures. I'm like, damn, my face was looking like my neck and everything like that. So I'm like, okay, she look a little slim. You feel amazing after even 30 or 40 minutes. Yep. An hour workout. Everything counts. Yeah. Oh, you're glute. That's amazing. I ain't got there yet, girl. I want to be. This girl that I follow, and I actually went to school with her. Her name is Pretty Brown Vegan. She makes, I mean, some of the most amazing, like, she makes soul food, but it be vegan. It be looking fire. And, like, she's based, I think, now out of Texas. Her name is Shamika. You should definitely check her out, girl. Like, her channel is fire. It's called Pretty Brown Vegan. She be making sloppy joes, tacos, apple pies. I'm like, what the hell? So, I admire you. I hope one day I can go vegan, but it's hard, girl. I love my cheese and dairy. What else I can't give up? So I'm gonna try. Yeah. So yeah, like, so am I. I was like a size 11, 13. I'm like, well, it still kind of depends. Like, I'm like a 9, but that's more so like Fashion Nova because they jeans be stretching. But I'm really I'm usually like 11, 12 myself. So yeah. Are you pretty tall? How about say, cause you might be tall. Or girl, you just thick ones, okay? You a thick vegan. Period. Ain't nothing wrong with that. But no, I totally agree. That girl, how long you be working out for? I be working out for but them classes be 45 minutes. Y'all, this is what my tacos look like now. Can you see them? Ooh. I'm gonna put a little tomato on there too. You can trust me. Dairy was my, yeah. So was that like the last thing you did? Okay, oh, you 5'5", you slim. I mean, you a little short, little thickums, huh? Look, you you a big old booty. She said, I'm 5'5", girl, I'm 5'12". I'm 6 foot. Hold on, y'all. She said, I'm 5'5", brown eyes, smell like the sunrise. I don't remember how that song goes. I don't know how old you are, girl. If you a millennial like me, you know that song. Love your personality. You must be an earth sign. Oh, thank you. Girl, I ain't even gonna lie to you. I don't know what that means. I'm a Leo. I don't know. I don't know. What's that? Am I earth sign? Period. Y'all see my tacos? Ooh, ooh. It's giving Chef Boyardee. See, girl, this the problem right here. I can't get this up. Hey, she said, have a seat, haha, pop, girl. And people be like, oh, okay. And I'm like, I'm saying that because I don't want to say I'm 6 foot. I'm like, y'all a little slow. Yeah, baby, I'm 5'12". Because it sounds cuter, don't it? I don't want to be like, yeah, I'm 6 foot. I'm 5'12". Definitely. Okay. You just gonna eat the meat. Y'all see my tacos fire. Don't be dissing me. She said fire sign. Never mind. Girl, don't be saying it like that. See what I mean through. No, I love my girl. It be the sour cream that set the tacos off. Don't say that. What's a good vegan sour cream so I can go try it? Because I don't think they can do it. Baby, I ain't had Taco Bell in years. Best believe if I go to Taco Bell, baby, we're getting Supreme. Y'all, I'm gonna get my mukbang on, and I'm gonna let y'all go, okay? Mm-hmm. That's good info. Who did that?
You.
What's my name?
You.
Boy, you supposed to say mommy.
Oh, mama.
Oh, all
right.
I got mommy. Oh, they did. I'ma try. I'ma go. I mess with Whole Foods. I like Whole Foods and I'm starting to like Trader Joe's, like, even though I'm not vegan or anything. Oh. Not the PG. Look. Girl. Did you hear that? I'm sorry. Did you hear that? Meek Mill audio. What the hell? What the hell? Mm-hmm. I live in Indiana. Country ass Indiana. Indiana, Indianapolis. Yeah, I think we have a Sprouts here. I don't know. I might have to Google. I've heard of it before. I actually did a brand. It's kind of weird and I'm embarrassed to say this. I did a brand sponsorship with them a long time ago. But I don't think we had them here then, but I think they're here now. Baby. Did you hear them feet clapping? What did you say? I'm not the best reader, okay? Is it McDonough, Georgia? Never heard of that. Where is that at? Is that near Atlanta? I know Atlanta. I know Dublin. What else? Savannah. Yeah, them the only places I know in Georgia. Oh no, Macon. Girl, you black, right? I'm sorry, I have to add.
You are black, right?
She said cheese. Girl. I mean, I said Meek Mill? No. Okay, so it's an hour from downtown Atlanta. That's cool. It's funny because my husband, he's from Pennsylvania, and I'm from out west, and we be talking about, well, let me not say we. I be trying to convince my husband, like, hey, we need to move to, like, Atlanta because, well, not Atlanta. I want to move to, like, Marietta. Like, I be seeing some real nice houses out there, and the market is kind of similar to the ones here in Indiana. And I be like, man, we need to move out there because that's where all the black people, like, the successful black people at. DJ, don't cover me. I don't want to get on here because I be saying words wrong and people be coming for me, y'all. I'm like, damn, I don't be thinking about it like that. I got kids. I talk to these kids all day long. She's cape and beard. See, on me on here reading. I don't want y'all to be talking about me. Okay, girl, so you a little, like, okay. Like, not eyelid mix, but I get what you're saying. Okay, that's what's up. Does she like it there? She do. It's beautiful. Yeah, I like, girl, them houses, and like I said, as high as the shit is out here, I can afford to live out there. Girl. Y'all good. Y'all tore them tacos up. Okay, y'all. I'm sorry. Mama getting out. And I'm trying to read everything. But yeah, I want to move out there, like, so bad because, girl, ain't nothing to do here. I mean, we starting to have stuff to do here, but, Hold up. Now you're going to have me looking up McDowell. Okay, Siri, next song. Hey, Siri. Next track. I wasn't feeling that. Can I get some R&B? Oh, okay. I've never, like, is it, like, city-wise? I'm gonna look it up. Girl, I just be... I want to make sure you're black, right? I don't even try to offend nobody. But, like, I don't be want to... Like, my husband, he against it because he be thinking, like, they be still being racist down here. Guys, I'm sorry. This taco good. Girl, who is that? I don't know who that is. She said, who is Tia Kemp? Girl, not me living under a rock. I ain't got no friends. And I don't be talking to nobody, so I don't know who that is. Is that somebody on social media? Period. Okay, Siri, can I get a 2000? Hey, Siri. Can I get a 2000s R&B and hip hop? Because that's what I asked for. Damn. Period. Hold on. What did that say? Wait. That I love you. You sound like Tia Kemp. I don't know. Yeah, I don't know who that is, girl. No, seriously, your husband isn't wrong. Hold on. So, are you saying it is like that? Because that's not okay. It is 2024. Are y'all a real estate? I don't know who that is. I mean, I'm going to look her up. I never heard of her. Girl, I done had to cut my sister and then mom. I ain't got no friends now. Because people don't know how to act, okay? But I feel you. My husband is my friend. Hey, if you a millennial, I don't care what nobody say, that 2000, Tell Siri to play 2000s hip hop and R&B. It's gonna take you back. You know, when you was a kid, singing all that inappropriate music, you didn't know. I know you eat yourself. Why? Oh, ask me for another one. Oh, okay, because you were scaring me. But I second guess myself because I'm from... Oh, so you from... Yeah, girl, I heard about Boston. I'm talking about yesterday. Probably just hung somebody. I heard they are really funny towards us. Yeah, I'm the youngest of 10. Well, not biologically. I was adopted. I don't fuck with none of them. I used to be the person that would be like, oh, guys, let's get together. Let's hang out. And people don't know how to act, girl. People be trying to use you and want you to do for them. And then you don't, and then they can't do nothing for you. Can't get a babysitter. My parents were best friends growing up. I'm just not for a lot of stuff or just... No, for real. Hey, people out here is crazy. That's one thing that I'm really learning and really just... I don't know. I just, for so long, I don't know. It's probably because of my upbringing and not having shit growing up. Girl, I be thinking that, I don't know. I just be having a lot of faith in people. Well, I used to have a lot of faith in people. Not no more. Girl, Boston, I'm telling. I told you, my husband, he's from Pennsylvania. And I was like, oh, when we first got together and we used to go out there all the time. I'm like, oh my God, I've always, because I used to like the Boston Celtics back in the day. This is them Paul Pierce days, and you know what I'm saying? Like a long, long, long time ago. I'm like, oh, I want to go to Boston, you know what I'm saying? He was like, hell the fuck, no, you don't. And I was like, why you say that for, babe? And he was like, And then I used to watch this girl on YouTube. I don't know if you know who Kelly Stamps is. She lived in Boston for a while. And like I said, this was just like last year. Girl, the apartments, she tried to go rent an apartment, and they was like, oh, we're not going to rent it to you because you're black. In 2023? I said, oh. Okay. Yep. When you start spiritually elevating, getting closer to yourself. Yeah, but it's lonely. I ain't gonna lie, though. You know what I mean? Because, like, I like to have fun. I like to laugh. But you know what? That's one thing. I've really, like, just become my own friend. And, like, my kids are, like, my I don't want to be one of those parents like, my kids are my best friends, but they are. Like, they, baby, we be kicking it. We be laughing because we like to have a good time. They're like that, some folks. Yeah. But, girl, we can talk, you know what I'm saying? And that's another thing. I'm learning that, you know what, maybe it's just best to kind of, like, keep your distance because I've learned in the past, like, I be all in and, like, I don't think people can handle that. Like, if I'm your friend, baby, I'm riding or die. What you need me to do? I got your back, 110. And people be acting like, girl, I'm telling you, I have gave people cars. I have co-signed for people. I have done so many things. And I'm telling you, I can't even get a babysitter, bro, for like 2 hours. People be like, but yeah, you asking me for money, $1,000 here. You know what I mean? Like, crazy. So I'm just like, but no, I appreciate you saying that. That's what's up. And girl, I feel you. You know, you be on your journey too. Like, but haven't you seen since you've cut, like, a lot of people off, like, blessings just be coming? That'd be the thing that'd be scary. I'm like, Jesus, I mean, you could have told me this a couple years ago, and I wouldn't have been wasting my time with these people. I become my own best friend, too. Yeah. Girl, because I like to laugh. Like, man, when I'm telling you, like, I'm a fool in real life. Like, I don't be getting really get to, I feel like, and that's why I keep saying I'm about to get back into vlogging and stuff. Because, baby, when I tell you, we be having... Yep, it's nothing like inner peace, man. And you know what's so crazy? As much as I be saying, like, oh, I want to have friends. I love the fact that my phone ain't blowing up. Because when it was blowing up with problems. Can you come save me? Can you do this? Can you bail me out? Can you give me some money? Like, I live a peaceful life. Like... I really do, you know, and I guess that's like the give and take. I can tell because of your shorts. Yeah, girl, I'm, hey, oh, thank you. I really appreciate you. You so cool. Yeah, that's That's crazy. And that's what I'm saying. Like, but don't get me wrong, like God has, and that's the thing where I had to like sit back and kind of have a conversation with myself and be like, God has always blessed me. Don't like, and that's the thing, like when I even had to ask myself, I'm like, God, why do these people keep doing me so dirty? Like, cause I'm telling you, like, I don't know if you ever got a chance, but like, and maybe you can relate to it. I posted a podcast episode talking about like F friends, and I kind of was explaining like all the things that I had been through just within the last year and how I'm always like helping people and pouring into people, and like a motherfucker can't even share a goddamn post, a person can't even like a video, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, bro, you're in it, you know what I mean? Like, and people be, I don't know, you know, but it was like at the end of the day, regardless, when I kept asking myself, it was like God revealed to me and was like, but you won't ever want for nothing, and be thankful that you're in a position to even help people, because some people aren't even in a position to help people. So I had to learn to like be grateful for that alone, and even though it didn't work out or whatever, these people are missing me, I don't miss them. So I'm sure in your case it's the same situation, it's their loss that, you know, you are no longer in a life. So fuck y'all. With love. With love, okay. We think our blessings, we think blessings are external. Girl, I was a fool. I'm learning. I'm waking up now. I had to talk to God, and he said to me, don't think something is wrong because you're not like everyone else or have a bunch of people like I used to hang out with. But he's telling me I'm bringing you higher. Yes. Same. Same. That's, oh, and look, you just said same too. Same. That's crazy. Someone tried to snap that. What you mean? You talking about on here or to you? No, but for real. No, for real. And that was the thing. But I'm just like, because, you know, I ain't gonna lie, when you be scrolling through Instagram and stuff like that, you be seeing these girls on these little girl trips, you like, man, I want to have that. Like, bro, I want to, you know, she got to be cute. You know what I'm saying? Have, you know, have a little aesthetic about her too. That's important. I'm gonna be honest. And, you know, I just kind of always wanted that, you know. And it's like, I go on vacation with my husband, and it's like, don't get me wrong, my husband is my best friend. But it's like, when we be having our little, which we really don't even be getting into it, but like, cause I'm really a toxic person, but he don't be allowing that shit, girl. I be trying to, babe, I'm mad at you, I want to fight, and he be like, girl, whatever. And I'm like, damn, I need some drama in my life, but he don't be falling for it. But no, like, I just be wanting that outside, you know, like outside of him, because it's like he has his, you know, his friends and stuff where they have God moments, but I'm like, I don't have my little. I don't have my girl moments, but yeah. But when you said, I'm sorry, girl, I got ADHD, so I'll be snapping all over the place. When people lose us, we go hard for people around us in every way, really ride no joke. Yeah, but you know what? At the same time, I keep telling myself, that's what makes us in general dope individuals, because it's like, I don't take back none of that shit. I don't regret none of the stuff that I've done, because like I said, once again, God has continued to bless me. God has continued to, I mean, like, I don't want for nothing. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, at the end of the day, these people, yeah, you got something out of me or whatever like that, money, whatever that is. But it's like, bro, I got 10 times that amount anyway. So I don't care. And like I said, God continues to bless. And it's like, I feel like that's what's wrong with the world nowadays. It's like, people don't even value being just a good-hearted person. That is, like, important. You know what I mean? It's not about how you look. It ain't about none of that. It's like, I really value being a good-ass person. Rather that I make somebody laugh, I brighten somebody's day. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's important, because you never know. Like, you holding the door and saying, oh, girl, your outfit is cute, that could change a whole person's, you know, outlook on life that may have been going through something. And, you know, like, so it's really important to be a good person. So I feel you. What she said? Girl, I'm sorry. This is going, I can't. Told you my ass a little slow. LOL, you're funny. You have some, girl, I'm crazy. Psycho. I do, girl, I be trying to fight. But he don't be, I'm telling you, do you be wanting to do that? Like, I be like, babe, I'm packing my shit up right now and I'm leaving. And he be like, here go your suitcase, and roll that bitch to me. I'm like, babe, you supposed to be trying to fight for me, and be like, nah, girl, I don't want you to leave. I'm down on bending knee. He be like, hey, just leave my kids here, I'll talk to you later. I'm like, damn. I said, I'm staying at a hotel tonight. He said, all right, give me some of their breakfast in the morning. I'm like, damn. What's it say? You got me. Hey, girl. Exactly. How we handle our own shit and handle, there's no pressure and they can't even return a favor. It's okay, but we, okay. Naturally like this, though, we don't need something. I'm not good at abbreviations. What's that mean? to make us good hearted. Yeah. No, absolutely. No, for sure. You're right. And that's what I'm saying. Like, I'm like, baby, you done came to me. But the thing about it is, people be, well, you said, now I ain't gonna lie, this is the part that used to piss me off. Like, my husband and I, in the beginning of our relationship, we like sacrificed and would work. I was on this fucked up ass job. DJ, you in here, so you know. I was on this fucked up ass job that I was on for years, going through it with all these people and just craziness. And girl, we sacrificed like 5 years of like stacking our money. And people would be going on vacations. I mean, living their best life, coming to us, asking us for money. And we would give it to them. And I'm like, damn, I ain't going on no vacations. I ain't buying no new car. I'm not getting nothing like this. But you coming to me, but you can't pay your rent. You can't do none of that. But there's, and still 10 years later, they're still doing the same shit. So, DJ said, all about good karma. Okay, Jesus. Okay, amen. OMG, you sound like me. LOL, I say that all the time. I create joy everywhere I go. You never know, people's days, trauma, and pain give you love, peace, and lightness. Absolutely. Okay, girl, these men out here don't be understanding. I want a, maybe because I be watching Tubi. I be watching Tubi all the time. And I'm a little dramatic. I know. But I'm like, you need to fight for me. He be like, hi. I'm here, ain't I? I'm like, that's not all. I need more. I need more, okay? But no, back on when we was talking about serious stuff. But no, yeah, like, I was the type of person, I used to deal with depression a long, long time ago, girl. And like, you never know, little things be triggering you. Like, a motherfucker be like, go kill yourself now. You be like, you know what I mean? So you really, people don't be understanding. You gotta watch what you say, man. Cause that shit ain't cool. Like, so that's why when I be seeing people, I be like, okay, girl, I see you. You know what I'm saying? Because a motherfucker be like, okay, I thought I was looking a little chubby today. I needed to hear that. Thank you. Yo, I'm about to get off of here because I got to put these kids, well, my daughter, her little dusty self in the tub. She was painting earlier. So it's a hot ass mess. But dude, this was fun. I like talking to y'all. I like when y'all be talking back to me. Everyone says to me, you make my day. Girl. No, for real. And that's the thing though, but don't that kind of like bring you up just a little bit? Like when somebody say, oh, you made my day. And I'm like, meanwhile, I'm over here struggling, crying and shit. But at least you're happy. I made you happy, so I'm happy now, I guess. Fuck. I've watched. Girl, okay, so we don't have to get together because baby, people don't be understanding Tubi. When I be telling people I be watching, they be like, girl, you watch Tubi. And I'm like, yeah. Baby, I'm on the watch list, baby. I gotta look. You know you dedicated to Tubi when you gotta sign in, cause you know motherfuckers don't sign in to Tubi because you don't have to. The shit's free. But yeah, girl, we gonna have to. I don't wanna. Let me know if you have Instagram so I can follow you and stuff. What'd you say? Yes, it does. LOL, bring me up. No, are you talking about when we talking about the comp? Girl, I'm sorry. See, this is why ADHD. What was we talking about? I forgot. You about to get in the tub. But I hope everybody's having a good night. I love talking to y'all. So y'all, I think I'm gonna go live every day. I'm gonna be consistent, okay? Cause y'all don't give a fuck about me working out no more. Right? Okay, bitch, we've seen you. We get it. You're consistent. Hey, I had some people saying that in my thing, like, okay, bitch. Okay, we get it. You're working out every day. No one cares. I'm like, I was just trying to inspire. I just thought I was inspiring someone, but I guess not. What is that? Yeah. Where am I at? Yeah, that's good. That's what I said, but you just be having to like, okay. But that's God though. That be God trying to like make you see like, bitch, be grateful now. Damn. I'm sorry, y'all. Me and Jesus be cussing at me and so we have, I don't want nobody to be offended. Sometimes I be cussing and I'll say Jesus 5 minutes later. But I'm not a Christian. I'm a spiritual and I love Jesus. So don't come for me if anybody come back and watch this. Cause see, people be trying to come for me in the live after the fact. And I'm like, but you ain't had that shit to say when I was in your face. Yes, people say that to me, but Tubi, black cinema. Girl, I got some movies for you. That's why I said you had to give me your Instagram and stuff because baby, I need to be, I said I need to reach out to Tubi because I need to be an ambassador, honey. What do you mean? They should be happy to see someone committed. People are, okay, girl, I'm like, they are so fucking mean. But I don't care. Like, you know how people be saying, like, oh, I don't read the comments on social media because it gets to me. I be thinking that shit is funny. Hey, people be on my motherfucking head. I be like, bro, that was a good one, though. You got me. Like, one day, I ain't gonna lie, y'all. I had on a, like, I be wearing these little, like, this is a little half wig and stuff. You know what I'm saying? I ain't got no edges right now either. But, like, I had on my ponytail, and it was, like, I guess it was, like, wobbling or whatever. It was, like, your ponytail about to fall off. I was, like, you got me. You right? I mean, I'm not bald-headed, though. I just happen to be wearing a ponytail right now. You know what I mean? You working out consistent keeps me consistent, because I be, like, okay, period. It's a competition. I ain't losing more weight than DJ. I ain't lost no weight. Anything, I'm gaining. What the fuck? That's why I'm trying to be a runner, y'all. I'm like, I'm doing cardio. I don't know. You know, I be watching all these damn videos. I didn't watch everything from, you're an, what is it called? I was going to say a morphodike. An endomorph. I'm doing intermittent. I'm just trying, you know, but at the end of the day, like I said, consistency has been the key. And making it a lifestyle routine, because I want to be, y'all be seeing them 70-year-old, 80-year-old people and they be like cock diesel and shit. I'm trying to be like that. Angela Bassett. I mean, I'm not built like her, obviously, because she's little as hell, but mama fine. Regina King, them hoes is fine. I'm like, I want to be that. Now, if anybody that I would compare my body to, I guess you could say Megan Thee Stallion, because she's like 5'10". But like, I want to be like, I'm trying to be cock diesel, you know what I'm saying? I want to be like, okay, this be, you know what I mean? But I got boobs, so I feel like I won't look too cocky, because I, you know, I think girls be looking muscular when they don't have a chest, you know what I mean? I fast half the day, like 18, god damn, girl, not 18. Is that what I do? Fast half the day, like 18 hours and eat one meal. I was thinking about doing that, but I forgot what I read or something like that. Because it's called like the OMAD or whatever like that. But I mean, yeah, you see, you vegan. So I guess that's why. Because maybe when I was trying that, they was like, you can eat whatever you wanted because you're only eating one meal a day, right? And like, I don't know. I just, like, do you count calories and macros and do all? See, I can't do all that. It's too much. I do intermittent fasting. I try to do like 11 to 7. And I don't know, like, I mean, I it's helped, but I don't know. I don't know. I want some instant results. I don't want to get no BBL or no lipo or nothing, but it's just like, I just want to like tone my stomach down, get rid of my little mommy pooch. And then, like, I just want my arms to be, you know, a little bit more. Everything else, I don't really care. Like, I've never been a person that had a big butt or anything like that. But like, I mean, apparently I got a little hippy hip now. I got a little something back there now, but, yeah, I'm not like super like, oh my God, I need to be like this. I just really care about my arms and my stomach. That's really like my back. I don't think I got a big back or anything like that. I'm always full. Girl, my vegan lifestyle. What is my vegan lifestyle? I am mindful of my ingredients and put it in my body. Yeah, and that's really what I'm, because you know, this food ain't getting nothing but worse. But girl, I ain't gonna lie, them tacos that I just ate, they was good. They was fire. And that be my thing. Like, I keep saying I'm gonna make some of them. Do you be making them tacos with like the walnuts? Y'all, once I hit an hour, I'm gonna get off of here, because I don't wanna talk y'all to death, because I could talk all day. But yeah, I've been wanting to make, it's like, you, is it walnuts? And then some people say you use mushrooms. I feel like I might like the mushrooms a little bit better though. I don't do calories. I do one meal a day, but it's all about your ingredients and your food. But I mean, when you do, like, is it like a salad? Oh yeah, you can have a salad. I was about to say a piece of fish. You know what I mean? Like, that's what I was doing when I was doing the OMAD, because I would have like a big ass salad. It would have, I like just usually like spinach or spring mix. So I'll do like spinach, tomato, egg, chicken, bacon, salmon in that bitch, all in the, you know what I mean? Because I'm like, baby, I gotta get full. I gotta get my nutrients. And then I would drink like a, that's probably why I was getting bigger. Now that I think about it, saying it out loud. And then I would have like a protein shake with it. Maybe that's why I got bigger. And like, I felt like I was, that's why I said I switched now to intermittent fasting, because I'm like, girl, but see, vegan, I feel like, hey, you can't do nothing wrong, because everything you eating is healthy. I do not do, where was I? They look good. Maybe they was. You talking about them tacos? Tacos was fire. Girl, that's what I'm saying. That's what I'm like. And that's like my favorite. Yeah, I would say tacos and Philly cheesesteaks, baby. I don't need nothing else in this world but tacos. Because I mean, any taco, a chicken taco, a shrimp taco. I got all that shit. Chicken taco, shrimp taco, steak taco, baby pork taco. I just had a pork taco for the first time a couple of weeks ago, and I didn't know. You see what I mean? But I don't really mess with pork like that. I try not to. But yeah, girl, you my inspiration. You my inspiration. Like I said, I'm definitely going to I'm gonna be hitting you up because I need some recipes. But it's baby steps. Slutty V and makes the best Philly cheesesteak. I want to check them out. I think we got one here. Or where have I heard of Slutty V? Is that, I think it was in Miami. Maybe I was in Miami when I... Because, girl, we ain't got nothing here. They do have a couple little vegan spots, but they like mom and pop shops. Use low-carb taco shells. Mm. I can't have these. What are these? These are low-carb. Hold on. And see, okay. See, that be the problem, y'all. I don't know. What is low carb? Because that's what I'm saying. I think that's where I be messing up. Because I'm like, these in two shells, they say they have 18 carbs. That ain't a lot, right? I do fresh juices, wellness shots every day, and the teas. Mm-hmm. Soups or salads, veggie sandwich. I can't do all that fake vegan meat. Oh, so you don't like it? Because I'm about to say, I've been wanting to try that. They sell it at Kroger. I don't know if you have a Kroger where you live. It's called, what is it called? And it comes in like a green pack. I keep saying, I was like, because the girl I was telling you about, Pretty Brown Vegan, she makes a chicken Alfredo and she uses it. And she says it's good, you know? Where was I at? I'm sorry, y'all. I'm trying to... I don't know who you... Y'all, I'm telling y'all, I can't... I don't know who you are, but this is entertaining. Oh, thank you. Thanks. Gluten-free taco shell. Okay, with the gluten-free, y'all. It's, gluten-free. I don't know about gluten-free. It sound nasty when you say it. But I want to be healthy. I do. Gluten-free taco shells. Gluten-free helps stomach weight and the digest. And that's what be the thing. Girl, because I have my days where a baby stomach be flat. I mean, I be having abs. And then I be having them days where I'm like the Michelin man. I be juicing too. That helps and keeps you feeling great. It do. But y'all, juicing be making me... I mean, I'm talking about all day long. I be moving everywhere. I'm like, ooh. And then I'm getting... Baby, I'm getting a little older. I'm like, baby, the body don't work how it used to. I be like, ooh, I'm gonna go. Because... juicing is dangerous. It's all about how you season it. Okay, I'm going to give it a try. You're going to have to give me some recipes, girl, because like I said, I really do. And it's hard going vegan in a household where everybody don't eat the same shit. You know what I mean? Like, I be trying to put them on, and they like, this shit is disgusting. Like, the kids, my husband, everybody. That's the point. But all, girl, it be coming out like water. Here I am. I'll be like, ooh, I'm a little gassy. I gotta go. That's getting that stomach black. No, for real. Hey, I drink this. Look, let me show you. This, y'all know that Keisha Kyora tea? I had did a little sponsorship with her. Girl, fuck her. No, but, her tea, I ain't gonna lie. It do work, but her out here charging people $50, $60 for that stuff. Baby, here. You about getting tub. I be drinking this tea right here. I don't know if it's vegan or natural or nothing like that. But baby, and let me tell you how ghetto I am. I get it from my beauty supply store, right? Baby, this tea right here. Whew. Let's just say my husband don't fuck with me for a couple of days. He be like, stay over there. Because baby, I be like, baby, I be over beatboxing. Because that stomach be, whew. So maybe that's what I need. And that's probably what I need. But yeah, juicing, I don't know. Y'all like juicing like celery or do y'all like doing... Because now they saying, what is it? Too much fruit and stuff is bad. I'm just like, look. Every shit that I be trying, now y'all saying it's bad for you. You know, they saying too much watermelon now is bad for you. I love watermelon. That's like my favorite fruit. And then now they... You can... Did you know you could drown drinking too much water? I'm like, what the hell? Like, I just... What is healthy? Air? That ain't even healthy. Ancient Chinese secret tea. Is that a real tea? Baby, this tea costs $5. Okay, that's all she wants to spend. But I'm telling you, you put two of these bad boys, I usually put them in like a mason jar. Cause like I attempt to meal prep most days I do. Just not today, as you can see. But yeah, I put them in a, like a little mason jar, let that bad boy sit, because that's how you do the Keisha Kaiori tea, and it's like the longer it steeps or whatever, really just sit. I'll put that bad boy in the refrigerator, but initially I'll let it sit hot and let it get dark as hell. Use like two of them bags, baby. I mean, you can shit out 10 pounds in like out a few hours. But that's why I really be, I really don't like to drink it like that, because I be going to these workout classes, y'all, and I be in front of these white people, and I be, hey, y'all, like, and I don't, you know, I'm the only black person in there most of the time, and I don't want them to be like, we know it's the black girl here pooting in our face. So that's why I usually wait till the weekends to drink that tea. But I, like I said, that's my little, like, I guess you can say, like, how you said you be juicing and stuff, girl. That's what I be doing. What'd you say? It don't work. Hey, Xavier, that's my son's name. Yeah. Period. I love Xavier's. You really gonna eat this whole bag of cheese, girl? I don't, it don't work. It do work. Or what you mean? Are you talking about juicing? I mean, girl, you got a job. She said, not, I don't work. You got a job. Okay, period, girl. Okay. I thought you were talking about the tea. Are you talking about the tea? It's okay, girl. Look, y'all about to make me make some tea tonight. Because I need to get rid of these tacos. And that'd be another thing. I'm like, is that lightweight kind of like, is that almost like being bulimic? Can I say that on here? Is that like being the B word? You know, you can't say stuff like that. They'll block you on YouTube. But I need to make that because I need to get rid of that. What? Girl, what you talking about? What'd I say? I told you I got ADHD. I forget. Detox tea shits your... Girl. I'm telling... Baby. And let me tell you something. I don't know. This is why I don't need to be on the live, because I be saying some inappropriate stuff and I'm going to get blocked. But let me tell you something. I don't know how they do it. Because, baby, I wouldn't want nobody back there. You said, shit, your whole girl. Nigga, your life, your ancestors, and, shit. No, for real. For real. Like I said, them Keisha word, look. But you don't even need that. I'm telling you. I put like, they come in like twos like this. They ain't got no bag on them or nothing, y'all. I drop them in the water. Let the water sit. Honey, I'm telling you. You got an event or something you need to do? Need your stomach to go down real quick? Baby, I'm telling you. Just don't go nowhere. I mean, you need to go somewhere. You got to plan it out. That's the thing I've learned about detox tea. You have to plan. Okay, if I drink this tea, I got about 3 hours. Before I can do something. If not, I need to keep my ass on, because I'm not a public bathroom user. Can't do it. It's just, I can't do it. I mean, squatting and all, I can't. Once, and you know what it was? It's because one time my booty, y'all, it grazed the wall, and I just felt like I had, I don't know, something on my booty, like for life. So I just, like, I don't know what I'm gonna do. I have a 2-year-old girl that I'm potty trained. I'm like, what are we gonna do when we go out of town? But they have these little portable things you can use the bathroom on. Y'all, I'm about to get off here. I'm sorry. I told you I could talk y'all to death. But thank you guys so much for joining me. I'm gonna see you. Well, I see you guys tomorrow, same time. That's right, girl. Cause you look crusty. But all right, y'all. It was so nice talking to you guys. Girl, I'm gonna find you on here, and I'm gonna find out how to say your name, cause I don't know how to say it. Like, can you put it in? You know how they be putting the pronunciation? And it'd be something so simple. Because I be reading it all the way wrong. But okay, guys. Y'all have a good night. I'll see you guys maybe tomorrow. Maybe tomorrow live. Let's say 8 o'clock. 8 o'clock p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Your girl will be here. I'm just playing. No, I might be, y'all. Because tomorrow Friday. And me and the kids, we be out in the streets, baby. We be at the park at Sky Zone, okay? Yeah, I thought I was about to say I'll be at the club. No, not at all. Baby, I be at motherfucking Target with the kids. That's what we do on Friday nights. But yeah, I'm about to go. Well, okay, y'all. Have a good night. Remember, mama loves you. And I will see you guys tomorrow. Bye. Y'all see how she gotta make it about her? This is my life. I'm the star of the show. I'm just playing. All right, guys. Have a good night.